Have you ever wondered what games you should keep or you should lose? Find out here at Purge Reviews.
The second solo variant is called Solo Puzzle. You're going to take four of these inspiration tokens and set them on the side of the board over here. You will also have four inspiration tokens that are your own as you play the game. Now, the game's going to play a little bit differently. When you want to spend the inspiration tokens, normally if you want to take this card right here, I'd put an inspiration token on each one. Then I would take this card and everything would scoot down. In this variant, you do not do that. Instead, you're going to place them over in this supply if I want to take this card. And then these cards would be discarded out of the game. So I've taken this card now and the remainder of these are going to come down and fill in the additional spaces here. So that's kind of how that would set up. Now, whenever you want to take the leftmost one, that's fine. You may take that one and you would gain one of these inspiration tokens for doing so. And then like normal, everything is going to slide down and fill in accordingly, just like the regular multiplayer game. Then whenever you complete a painting, just like normal, whenever you complete a painting and that's one of your actions, then you can also take an inspiration token from the side over here. The game also gives you some scoring elements that will be on the bottom here. So you can always utilize this. 24 points of participation, 40 plus is best in show. So that can definitely help you as you're going through about what score you want to get. And each time you play, you can better your score as you're going through. Now, as for a solo experience, I think I like this one better. This puzzle aspect kind of plays into what I enjoy about the game more versus the painting with Vincent where it's kind of more randomized where you're flipping these up. In this case, I am managing not only this pool over here and what I want to accomplish, but knowing that if I don't take that card, it's going to come out of the game immediately and I'm getting fresh cards all the time. So I really need to make meaningful decisions. If I want this card, I could take this card and then that card and that would be a sufficient move. But I don't want these. They're just going to be out of the game. It's just going to cost me these inspiration tokens to do that, which I can earn back by taking maybe this card here when it's there. So that's just something to kind of think about and to puzzle through as you're going through. And this one is really well named as a solo puzzle. It really feels more like a solo puzzle. And I think I like that better than randomization of the other one. So I think I would probably give this one probably an 8, another one maybe a 7, where I feel like this is really the solo experience that I would be looking for. If you're looking for a simple to play where you like the idea of creating these pictures that we're creating and the artwork that's coming out of it and matching the icons, this is a really fun way to play it. Now, either one of these solo experiences I think are fine. This is probably the one I would prefer to invest my time in and play this one more often. And I would say if you're looking for the game, this is a great one to try out solo before you even play the multiplayer and kind of get the rules down. Excellent, excellent solo variant here. And I liked it quite a bit.